lives, and that's something worth living for. And so, Ed, my hat's off to you. And I'll be back at the Seven O's. I can't come tomorrow because I got a birthday to go to, but next Thursday I'll be there. But don't ask me to play Sally Gooden because I can't. And anyway, and then, so after Mama's Marmalade, I'll just say a word now about Dave. I could say a lot of words about him, but I talk too much anyway. But let me just say, there are a few guitarists in the bluegrass scene. I grew up listening to Doc Watson and Tony Rice, for instance. Yeah, and if I were young today, I'd be listening to Dave Grier. And I already do listen to Dave Grier, as well as people like Brian Sutton and other luminaries in the bluegrass world. But Dave is the real deal, and you're gonna really enjoy his stories, perhaps, anecdotes. He drove up here from Nashville to play here, and he's played with everybody. And maybe I'll just leave it at that, because you just sit back and be amazed by his virtuosity on the guitar. Let's see, do I have anything else to say? I'm planning concerts daily. I'm adding more shows to Watermelon Wednesdays. We'll have a show here on April 27th, that's a Wednesday, with Hanukkah Cassell and Keith Murphy and maybe a couple of others playing sort of Celtic tunes, mostly tunes, I believe. Hanukkah is a teacher online music video series called Peghead Nation. It's really great. It's really great instruction. So when you do decide finally after tonight to take up that instrument you've always wanted to, you can go to Peghead Nation and learn how to play it. So that's great. All right. And then, I have Tim Kliphaus coming on June 15th. He's the gypsy jazz fiddler. And then I have lots of other people that I'm super excited about. One is the Dedicated Men of Zion and Ladama, and those are two different groups. They're very different groups. One is all black guys singing gospel, and the other is Latinas singing a lot in Spanish, and they're both kick-ass groups that are going to blow the roof off wherever they play. Yeah. So anyway, without further ado, mechanics. The bathrooms are downstairs. Just go down the stairs here. And they're in the hallway, can't miss them. Let's see, what else? There'll be, Mama's Marmalade is gonna play for about half an hour, and then we're gonna take a mini break, because I know a lot of people don't wanna congregate and mill around with COVID and all that stuff. But we will have brownies available for free for any of you who want a little sweetness for dessert, because I know you probably rushed here right after dinner and didn't get your dessert. And then Dave will come on and play about 90 minutes worth. And that'll be more notes than you could possibly imagine you could hear. You'll be satiated with notes. Okay, do we have a bluegrass band named Mama's Marmalade in the wings?
Delighted to be here. We're gonna kick things off with a tune from our most recent album called Don't Call Me Lonesome.
If I don't pick up the phone, I just turn off that TV, thinking to myself a while. And don't call me lonesome if you can't see me smile. Don't call me lonesome, I just need a little while. Don't call me lonesome if I don't come out today. twist them till they're blue. And don't call me lonesome, cause darling, it ain't true. Don't call me lonesome, don't believe the
is coming back to your hometown.
We're going to do an instrumental now that our guitarist over here, Sean Davis, wrote. And,
as a dreadnought guitar player, it's such an honor to be opening up for David Grier. He's like a superhero to us, for real. Yeah, this is an instrumental. Let's see. Two. One, two, three, go. Sean wrote that song when he got his wisdom teeth out. You can hear it, right?
Doesn't that happen to everybody?
Yeah, that's where, like, you know, every artist thrives.
Need a place to hide. She walks through the
Ed Sherman, who I know you just heard a long spiel about the jam that we do on Thursdays, but it is pretty fun. I have to plug it here myself. Keeps us really fresh once a week. We're gonna do another original instrumental for you now, and this is the title track of our release that we put out last summer called Rabbit Analog, and the song is called Rabbit Analog. We hope you like it. y'all have been so lovely. We're going to play just two more for you. We're going to play you a gospel number. Common in a bluegrass set. You got to have at least one. Hopefully just one.
Depends on which bluegrass band.
I guess you're right.
Only one for us.
Only one for us. That's all we got the stomach for. If you have friends in Providence, Rhode Island, we're going to be there 1 week from today at Nicanese, which is a fabulous establishment. They do a Bluegrass Wednesdays that Sal Sacco has been running for probably decades. So if you have friends out that way and you want to send them down, that's 1 week from today. And other than that, we're just kind of cooling our heels, making a record until the summertime, and then you can catch us all over the U.S., really. We're going everywhere this summer. But in the meantime, here's Man in the Middle. Sean's going to sing it for you.
You're going to kick it.
Well, yeah. One, two, three.
City man, tied to the cross he bled. He could have been forgiven, but he mocked the Lord instead. You say you are the Son of God. Well, he nailed you to that tree. Come down and save us. God, your Father, be. Free man on a mountain. On Calvary, and the man in the middle was Jesus. He died for you and me. Was a sinner too, but he was sorry for his sins. He begged the Lord's forgiveness, and Jesus said to him, fear not this earthly death, because before this day is old, you'll be with me in paradise on heaven's golden shore. On Calvary, and the man in the middle was Jesus. He died for you and me. Three men on a mountain. Up on Calvary, and the man in the middle was Jesus. He died for you and me. Three men on a mountain. Up on Calvary, and the man in the middle was Jesus. He died for you and me.
We're gonna do one more quick one for you, and we really have to do this one because our friend who wrote it is in the house tonight. So this song goes out to Ali Telmasani, and we hope we do it justice. This is the Chicopee Kid.
Chicopee nuts.
Where is he even? There he is.
It's for you.
It'll be a long time. he speaks kind of divine. No, he never did no wrong, oh, it's true by design. You may call me a fool, but I'll pay you no mind. Oh, I gave my heart to the Chickadee kid, Lord, I gave my heart to the Chickadee kid.
There's a break in the action. There are brownies downstairs. Just go down, grab one, and go outside or somewhere safe. We're changing scenes a little, and then we'll come back in 5 or 7 minutes. And then David will come on and do a one long set, 90-minute set maybe, maybe 85 minutes, maybe 95, who knows. But anyway, thank you so much for being here. This is tremendous. I'm really overwhelmed. So this is great. I hope you like Mama, and I know you like David, so go out and buy some stuff. He's selling merch out there, or Claudia is for him, and so is Mama's Marmalade. You can get some of their merch as well, and then we'll come back here and have the second half. second part of the show. I hope you've had a chance to look over Dave's merchandise out there. And I'm sure, I'm pleased to see he's selling CDs because my car still plays CDs. And so if you're like me, that's going to be a hot item. But what's hotter is what's in them. And what's in them is because of what's behind me. And lo and behold, there's a guitar player behind me. So put your hands together and, oh my God. There's a little wardrobe thing happening. Okay, I'll just say, David Grier is going to appear in this seat and he's going to play guitar like you've never heard. So it's a good job.
Howdy, folks.
Howdy.
Y'all don't say howdy up here, do you? You say wicked. I know that much. Wicked hot, wicked cold. It doesn't matter. It's wicked. That's how it is.
Wicked howdy.
Wicked howdy. Check that out. Wow, a little bit of everywhere right there. That's cool. Well, howdy. It's good to be here. It is. Got to be somewhere. Might as well be here. That's how I figured. Holy cow. Yeah. Tune in some more. That's all right. Gives me an excuse. Anyway, made it all the way up here with no speeding tickets, so that's good. That doesn't happen every time. This was in tune a couple days ago. I don't know what happened. Did he tell you I'm just going to do one set, one big long set? It's only going to be three tunes and then I'm out of here. He said, play as long as you want. I said, all right. Well, that's a pretty good deal. Well, I'm going to start with a waltz I wrote. It's on my evocative CD. It's one I wrote and it's kind of pretty. It's really pretty if you don't get out much. That one is. So yeah, we'll start off slow and taper off. Wouldn't want to work too hard. People might expect it or something. That'd be terrible. Why would you want that? Alrighty, well, let's start with that. It's a lot cooler downstairs. This is called High Atop Princess Cove. And I wrote it in Asheville, North Carolina, at a friend's house. She's way up in the mountains, way down in a holler. And I wrote it there, and I thought, well, I'll just call it Holler Waltz. It's a waltz. I wrote it in holler. Done. And the more I thought about it, I thought, well, this is kind of a pretty tune. Holler Waltz just sounds like you got your car up on blocks, you know, and it broke down another car somewhere in the yard, and broke down still in a working meth lab out there. So it wasn't that good of a title. So I had another, I needed a name, and my friend called. She goes, oh, Dave, because that's my name. She said, Dave, I found out the name of the holler I live in. I said, well, good for you, because I'm all romantical like that. She goes, no, you're going to want to know. I said, what is it? She said, it's called Princess Cove. I thought, well, there you are. That's a song title if I ever heard it. So it's called High Atop Princess Cove, Little Darling. Because if you put that little darling on there, it's more of a bluegrass song. That's where all the money is. All right. Mm-hmm. there's no chicken wire up front. I told them to put that up there in case. They said, ah, you won't have no problem with that. Yeah, you always wonder. So I'm glad y'all are cool. Anywho. So I wrote this song, I didn't know what to call it. My friend says, oh Dave, because that's my name. He said, you should call that one Cascade. The notes just fall right off the fingerboard. Yeah, sure, what do I care? So I put it out, named it Cascade, and it's on my Hootenanny CD, and that come out a million years ago in 98. Goodness gracious. Anywho, I discovered when you play up in Portland, Oregon, or Seattle, Washington, Bellingham, Washington, Vancouver, up there, northwest, and you say, howdy folks, I'm going to play a song I wrote. It's called Cascade. At the end of the night, these really pretty girls come up to you and say, oh, Dave, you're so deep and introspective. We'd like to get to know you better. And I'm like, yeah, that's me, sure enough. And so I started thinking of this tune as being the magic tune. And it was for quite a while, 2 or 3 years, it was the magic tune. And then I played in West Virginia and I introduced it and it was dead quiet, just like that. End of the night, everybody's gone. I'm waiting for the manager to get their money figured out so I can get paid, and I'm sitting there watching her. So I asked her, I said, have you been here all night? She was, honey, I've been here since 3:30 this afternoon. I said, that's great. Did you by chance happen to hear that Cascade? You know that magic song? She says, yeah, it's okay. I said, no, no, it ain't okay. I'll have you know it's the magic tune. She goes, ah, it's all right, maybe, I guess, sort of. I said, no, 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 not at all. None of that. It's the magic tune. She goes, it's all right, I guess. I said, you guess? She goes, yeah, I guess it's okay, but why did you name it after a dishwashing detergent? Right then, magic gone. Gone, West Virginia. That's what you get, I reckon. You know where the toothbrush was invented? West Virginia. Because had they invented it anywhere else, they'd have called it a teeth brush. That's true. Yeah, it's okay, I guess. Tell you a thing or something. Anywho, this is called Cascade, still. I don't know if it's magic or not. It's been a while. Let's see. Thank you. song that ends is a good song. Wicked good. Wicked. That's so funny. You don't hear wicked anywhere else, but you come up here, it's wicked this, wicked that, wicked cold. That's a wicked bunch of ice. It's like, okay. So funny. Oh, what about the Beatles? What about the Beatles? You hear about them all the time. They ain't been a band in a million years. Oh, but they're in the news, and they got something going. It's an anniversary or whatever. It's been a million years. We come buy our stuff again or whatever. And I used to be a big Beatles fan. I love the Beatles. And I got that Abbey Road CD. You know that. Well, everybody knows Abbey Road. I paid full price for it because I like the Beatles. I bought that record. I put it on. Then first few songs, it's beautiful. I loved it. It was so good. Beautiful melodies, nice harmonies. The playing was tasteful. It was gorgeous. And then they did that one song, was it Her Majesty? It was this long. I paid full price. They did a song that long. It's like, no, that's bullcrap right there. Like, they couldn't let George take a solo and then just repeat that verse again. That would have been something. But no, none of that. And I hated it. And I hated them, and I hated that, and I thought, what a bunch of crap. They're millionaires, and here I am struggling to pay for a record, and they put a dinky little song on there. It's not right. It ain't right. And then I wrote a little bitty song myself. Me and the Beatles, just like that. That's me over here. But now I'm fine with it. I'll do it for you. I love this song. Figaro, Figaro. Well, I didn't think you'd cheat on me till you had that ugly baby. Ain't the only one can make a little song, by God. Make my own little song. What about that? Fix their wagon. So, got the Book of Woe. I discovered, I've been playing guitar since I was six. So that's 54. I'm 60 years old. 54 years I've been playing. That's the oldest I've ever been, too. 60, but been playing a long time, and mostly I just play, but I discovered that people would rather hear really bad singing as opposed to really good guitar playing. So you're going to love this next song. This is one I wrote, because why not? I wrote this while I was at a bar, and with three other friends. Yeah, I know, I got three friends. Anywho, one of them must have been drunk or something, got all brazen. Let's see who can write the best song and come back in a month and the winner gets free drinks. I said, all right, but it shouldn't take you a month. Let's just meet here next week like we always do. See who's got the best song. All right. Now, I had no intention of writing a song because I got enough pressure, what with having to wake up and figure out when to go back to bed. It's taxing. So, I wasn't going to write a song. I just figured I would just buy my friend some beers because I'm sure I owe it to him. And I come up with this melody. I thought, well, looky there. And then I remembered that bet we had. And then I thought, well, all right. And I was at the airport and I wrote the lyrics down. And I got this song. It's called The Dust Bowl Dream, Little Darling. Because it's a bluegrass tune. And my buddy Jason Carter just recorded it. It's going to be on his brand new record with Sarah Jarosz sang on it. Boy, oh boy, is she a singer. Yeah. Yes, she is. If you don't know of her, check her out. Jason's record's not done. They're still mixing it. But this song's on there. It's also on my latest CD, Ways of the World. The purple one out there with the orange writing. Anywho, goes like this. I had Tim O'Brien sing with me. I thought that was pretty good. Till Jason had Sarah. It's like, well, darn. Should have got her. A whole lot prettier than Tim is. Figaro. Yep, perfect. All closed and tellers left town, and I don't think they're coming back either. So it looks like my money's all run away from here. Just got this nickel in the pocket of my shirt. So it's another day of toil and strife, living this dust bowl dream. The pain and the anguish that I've been through, why you just couldn't even begin to believe. It doesn't really rain here, just enough to tease. If I could feel the drop, I'd fall down to my singing to just a few years ago, and because I always thought you had to be really good, but apparently, I mean, it's amazing. I'm flabbergasted that people still, I mean, like it, and that's so cool. I used to thought you had to be the best in the world. I tried to be as best as I could and do the best I could at playing, and then, you know, started singing and nobody ran away. It was so nice is what it was. Well, let's just, we'll figure something out here. I don't know what, but we'll figure, I know what, I do know what. I'll do that, but first. Anywho, this is a song I wrote a while back. It's on that Hootenanny CD that Cascade is on. And on that record is Dirk Powell, and Tim O'Brien. It's just the three of us playing a bunch of old-time songs and a few that I wrote. And this is on there. It's one I wrote. And when I wrote it, I called it Have You Ever Been to England? Which is a long title. And somewhere down the line, after it came out, I got tired of saying all that for an intro. So now instead of calling it Have You Ever Been to England, I just call it Ben Dangling. And I think that says it all. That's all right, ain't it? I'm not quite sure what that means, but I've seen pictures. Anyway, this, I hear it as an old-time song, but every time I play an old-time song for my old-time friends, they're always, that ain't old-time. So what is it? Well, that's jazz. So no, look here. Just because you can't play it don't mean it's jazz. But anyway, I hear it as an old-time piece. Maybe I'm the only one. Whatever. Thank you. one's called Waiting on Daddy's Money. It ain't about me, but that's the title. Anywho, that's on my latest record, the Ways of the World CD back there. It's called Waiting on Daddy's Money. Ben Dingman's going to have to come around later on. Whatever. It's just like rap music. You heard one, you heard them all. They're all the same. What the heck? This is my newest one. I wrote this in February 8th. And me and my buddy Tom Utes. Tom is a songwriting machine. He and I wrote this. I kind of hear this one as being like a Norman Blake song a little bit. I don't know. Y'all know of Norman Blake? Oh, yeah. Norman's amazing. He's wonderful. He's an old-time country blues, bluegrass, folk guitar player. And mandolin and dobro, and he's wonderful. He's like a national treasure. He's way up there. He's like 90-something. Old as dirt, but by golly, he's great. Just the same. Anywho, enough about him. This is the one I wrote. I haven't recorded. Just like I said, the 8th of February I wrote this, 2022. It's brand new. The cool thing I like about writing songs, these ones, after I just told you they're all the same, is you get to do whatever you want. This one doesn't have a chorus, for example. There's no chorus. It's four verses. Last line's the same, every one of them. I like it. I like the difference. I like how everyone can be whatever it wants to be. Whatever I want it to be is better. Anywho. I think I'll walk the old rail line headed out of town. You never know just what you find when you look around. I'm trying to lose these doggone blues rambling round my mind. I never thought I'd hurt this bad being left behind. I never thought I'd mourn the best friend that I ever I never thought a man like me could ever feel this bad. It feels like light has left the world, some won't even shine. Never thought I'd hurt this bad being left up your guitar and you play the same darn three or four songs every day. Is that right?
Yeah.
Isn't that weird? I know more than that. I've already done more than that. I know more than three or four songs, but pick them up, Salt Creek. Hey, here's this one, then this one, then okay. I don't need to practice those. I got those down because I've been doing them for 50 years. But I don't know why. It's funny how we do stuff we don't need to do. So, instead of working on what we should and need work, what needs work, we just play what we already know that doesn't need work. Oh, yeah, lazy, I reckon. Anywho, I decided one day I wasn't going to play any song I knew. I was going to play a bunch of songs I didn't know. That sounds daunting, don't it? Like, how are you going to play a song you don't know? But you can. Songs that you don't think of when you're playing your guitar. You think, oh, fiddle tunes or this singing song or whatever. And there's a lot of tunes. And so, because I'm sick and tired of playing the same ones over and over, I thought I would play songs I didn't know. That I remembered from childhood or something, you know, like that one. Or... So, you know, the point being that we know a lot of tunes we don't play. And what also happens, and I'm sure you're the same way as me, is you end up not only playing the same tunes, but you end up playing them your same way. You got your favorite way of doing it, where you put in your cool lick that you invented. You're the only one. Oh, here it comes. Oh, I love doing that. Oh, I'm going to do it again. And you put it in every song, and before long, every song sounds alike. Because you're doing your lick that you think so cool, which in reality probably ain't. But we all do it. And so, how could I break the mold? I'll play songs I don't know. And so those were two, and some other songs, and I stumbled on these two, and I put them in a medley, and I had to work. You know, the object also wasn't to learn these songs. I'm way too lazy for that. There's other cooler songs to learn than Leave It to Beaver. Believe me. So the point was to play them from memory. Get the brain and the fingers to go to that note you hear in your head instead of that stupid lick you do all the time. So maybe then you could hear another stupid lick and play that for a while. Or, you know, you'd become more familiar with the fingerboard or whatever. Just break the same thing you've been doing. There's a word for it, but I'll damn if I can find it. Anywho, you'll recognize these two tunes. Thank you. which is redundant. Every fiddle tune's an old fiddle tune. I mean, who are you kidding? Right? So this is called Red Haired Boy, and this is another one I've been playing for a Brazilian years. So you get tired of it, so you change it. I'm way too lazy to learn a new tune. Might as well take what I already know, change that around. I'm halfway done because I already know it. So that's me, my laziness. Anywho, ends up the first part of this, first time through, and the last time through is in 7/8 time. Yeah, I know. That's spooky. Bluegrass, I know 2/4, 3/4, that's a waltz. Fo-fo, I know that. 7/8, what in the world? It's scary. It's like somebody put down a piece of music in front of you, 7/8. It's like, hire somebody else, Jack. But I'll tell you what, it's really easy. If you play 7/8 time like they do in Branson, Missouri, piece of cake. Easiest thing in the world. Watch this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Easy. It's no big deal. I worked myself all up over that. It's a piece of cake. I don't see what the big deal is. You want me to show you? Let me show you this. Can I show you this really cool trick? You got to do it, though. You got to do it with me. All right. Uncross your legs and sit like this. Just like this with your hands down on your knees like this. And take a normal breath, several, and try to register how far down in your lungs that goes. It's different for everybody, and there's no right or wrong answer. Just come up with wherever your average is. Take some normal average breaths, and when you got it, let me know. You're pretty good? You got a rough idea? We're good. All right, check this out. This floored me. So amazing. Turn your palms over and take that same breath. What do you see? What do you hear? What do you feel? Nothing? No, it's... I just want to see if you do it. No. Your breath goes deeper. Did you notice that? That's wacky, isn't it? Just from this, your breath goes deeper in your lungs. Not for everybody, just the cool people. Not for everybody. Some people it works and some it doesn't. Isn't that wild? 60 years old and I just found that out. And I didn't find it out, I never found it. Somebody told me. But that's cool. That's a cool trick. Anybody can do that. You don't have to be a genius, which is how come I can do it. Anywho, this is called Red Haired Boy, Little Darling. And it's 7/8 time. We've been through that. It's all magic. Don't try this at home. But you can show your friends that trick. Tell them you made it up. I don't care. Say, watch this. It's the coolest thing. Thank you. when you're starting out, well, I just started out writing songs, you know, about 5 years ago. You don't want to write about the same stuff everybody else writes about. You want to carve your own niche somehow, you know. Everybody sings about puppy love and grandma and, you know, whatever. So you don't want to sing about that. You know, that's been covered. So I was trying to figure out what I could sing about. And I thought this song come out in about 15 minutes. It's easy. This was called You're Dead. And so when you're starting to write songs, you know, I never listened to words. I'd listen to melodies. I like melodies. And I'd listen to syllables, how they would hit in places. But I never listened to the words. I mean, I know some words. Free bird, who doesn't know that? You know, but whatever. And so I thought, well, by golly, I done wrote a song. I better start paying attention. And I discovered everybody uses the same old words. Some of them use the same old phrases. How many songs have you ever heard? How many blues songs you heard starts like this? I woke up this morning. Of course you did. And then you finish the song. We know. Or how many old time songs has this in there? If you don't like my peaches, don't shake my tree. That's in like a Brazilian different tunes. So once I discovered, you know, you can use everybody else's words, songwriting got real easy. No big deal. I don't know why everybody doesn't do it. So this one's called You're Dead. Hills and through the woods, grandmother's house we go, laughing all the way, ho ho ho, merrily, 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 life is but a dream, but you wouldn't know. Was a lady who swallowed a fly. She swallowed a great many things, but she didn't die. It's 'cause she knew all the king's horses and all the king's men. But that wouldn't help you one bit. You're dead. That stone over your head. Why, it just goes to show everybody you're dead. So nothing was stirring, not even a mouse. Everything's peaceful now. You're gone from the house. And even though the sun shines more brightly than it ever, ever did, why, you wouldn't notice, because you're dead. I should play one. My favorite guitar player is Clarence White. Do y'all know of Clarence? Oh boy, good for you. He is the bestest, I mean, just absolutely. And Doc Watson's right up there too. And they both did this song. I think every flat picking guitar player learns this song. Because you have to, it's like it's in the Bible somewhere. This is called Black Mountain Rag. Y'all know this one, y'all play it, you've heard it. Yeah, well, this would be a good time to check your Twitter or something. Anyway, I'm gonna play it. Fisherman, he caught one this long. wicked long. This is one I wrote. It's called Weeks Turn to Months Turn to Years. Mr. Obvious. Can't fool me. It's called Soldier's Joy. You've heard this. You can't have lived this long without hearing this somewhere. And I guess it's a good tune. It's lingered for a while. It's still being played. So I play it and have for, you know, Clarence and Doc did it. Everybody plays this too. I discovered I could play it with one finger. And I'll give that a try. It's been a while. This is my first show since Thanksgiving, the day after Thanksgiving. It's the last I've been out playing, so a little rough, but that's all right. Whatever. It can only get better. That's how I'm looking at it. So, Soldier's Joy, little darling. Thank you. try that at home neither, folks. I'm sort of a trained professional. All right. Let's see. Here's a song. My father played the banjo. Did you all know that? So he wasn't a real musician, but he hung around. Yeah, that's right. And after Bill Monroe, we moved back to Maryland. It's where I grew up. I was born in D.C., grew up in Maryland. And he joined a band, an old-time band called the Strange Creek Singers, which was Mike Seeger and Hazel and Alice and Tracy Schwartz and my father. And Tracy and Alice and Mike, they all had kids. And they was my age, some of them. It was great fun. That's where I learned you can't outrun the sound of a banjo. But they cut this song. It's called I Truly Understand You Love Another Man. It was written in 1928 by a feller named George Shortbuckle Rourke of Pineville, Kentucky. I got it written down. There's no way I'd ever remember that. But it's a boring song. But I liked it, but it was boring. So I always tried to change it. And what happens when you change it? It just makes it worse. Okay. But at least I knew that. Okay, this is crap. Go just set it aside. Leave it alone. And then I'd forget about it for years. And then I'd think about, well, look at there. Here's that song. I like that, I think. And I'd listen to it. Yeah, sort of, but. And then so then I'd try to fix it, you know, and always, again, that happened 3 or 4 times. And then I fixed it again. And now I like it. I mean, I think the version's okay. That's what I'm saying. Is I don't know. Y'all let me know. Whatever. It's a blues song, so you don't have to sing it well. So I got that going for me. Does anybody know this song? Good, good. Oh, darn it. You do. Anywho, we'll be lenient. Never been born or died when I was young. I never seen those two brown eyes, heard that flattering tongue. Oh Lordy, heard that flattering tongue. I truly understand that you love another man, and your heart shall no longer be mine. I truly understand that you love another man, and your heart shall no longer be mine. So who will shoe your little feet? And who will glove your hand? Who will kiss your rosy cheeks when I'm in a foreign land? Oh Lordy, I'm in a foreign land. I truly understand that you love another man, and your heart shall no longer be mine. Understand that you love another man, and your heart shall no longer be mine. Remember what you told me, dear, as we stood side by side. You promised that you'd marry me, be no other man's bride, oh Lordy, be no other man's bride. I truly understand that you love another man, and your heart shall no longer be mine. I truly understand you love another man, your heart shall no longer be mine. I guess I got time for just a couple more, so I'll do that. And it's been really fun playing for y'all. Maybe you saw, maybe you didn't, but I've got some CDs out there. I got a tablature book if y'all pick, and that might help you. What'd I say? CDs, there's an instructional DVD, there's stickers. And what's special about those stickers is if you put them on your dartboard, it improves your aim. I don't know how that works. It's fascinating. T-shirts. There's stuff out there. There's posters. Goodness gracious. Everything but an old radiator is out there. Anyway, take some home. You know what happens? Is people come to the show, and they enjoy it. Most folks just have a good time. It's camaraderie. It's good to get out. How often do we get out nowadays? So this is cool. And you get halfway home and you think, I should have got one of them CDs. And then you feel bad. Because, you know, you can't find my stuff on Spotify or Tinder or wherever it is. So you have to look back there on that table. And if somehow, with this warning, you still end up leaving without one of those, I've got a website. It's davidgrier.com. You could go there. I've got 16 different records, well, CDs now, I reckon, available. Be the first on your block. And sure would help me out. Anywho, thank you all so much. Give yourselves a big hand for coming out and risking your life. I gotta do this. Me and my buddy Harry Clark wrote this. I wrote the melody to all of these songs, and I wrote some of the words. This I wrote about half the words, and Harry wrote the other half. It's called Bittersweet Blues. I played it for my friend, and she didn't like it. Well, she liked it, but she didn't think it was. So here's the deal. I'm gonna tell you all about it. I hate when people do this. I like if the song's any good, they'd get it. But no. So, it's this guy, and he's got a girl, and things are getting a little cold in their relationship. Then he really notices it on the next verse. Yeah, she's gone on the third verse. And the fourth verse, he finds somebody new, and you're gone. So that's about it. Now you know everything. ain't rocket science. Now it wants to be out. Yeah, the whole night, now it goes. What's going on with you? Well, maybe I should do another blues number since I ain't. I work hard every day just to bring home the money. I give it all to you, 'cause you were my honey. Roses were growing so strong and so sometimes when you're sleeping, I look at you and wonder where your meanness comes from, your father or your mother. Kindness once given now rarely does appear. There has not, you're always so far away, like I'm not even here. I disappear. Another gloomy day, though the sun is shining brightly. Need to figure out how to put this all behind me. Thought we were strong, your love for me was true. There has to be a better way getting over. What can one. So, do you want something pretty that you know you've heard before? Yeah. Or do you want to hear that Ben Dinglin song?
Yeah.
Ben Dinglin. Alright. If I can remember the doggone thing. I tried to remember it earlier. I tried to think and nothing happened. Anyways. Golly. Y'all like dirty jokes? Should I tell a dirty joke? Had you heard the one about the guy that had five penises? His pants fit like a glove. It's not that dirty a joke. But I love it. It's so quick. It's so quick and easy. There's no big setup, no big dang deal. Just bam, done. I like that. I believe that's it. I got that much of it anyway, we'll see. I break into Wildwood Flowers because I done forget. Thank you. White's my favorite guitar player. I told you that, and he still is, because it's been like 30 minutes, and I still feel the same way. This is one he did with his brother, Roland, in a band they had called the Kentucky Colonels, and it's called Dark Hollow. I bet y'all know this and heard this song. It's beautiful. Something like that. I'd rather be in some dark hollow where the sun don't ever shine than to be all alone, knowing that you're gone, but calls me to live. So blow the whistle. rather be in some dark hall where the sun don't never shine than to be in some big city in a small room with your love on my mind. So blow your whistle, freight train, carry me farther on down the track. I'm going the way I'm leading to, and I'm going, I ain't coming back. Thank you all so much. It wouldn't have been the same without you.